Hello there. Today I am going to be doing a different thing than what I said. I had said I was going to do something else when I announced what I was doing, and I'm going to do another dinosaur, actually. Hold on one second. I forgot to do something. So, this was the dinosaur that I'd done earlier, and I am going to be doing another dinosaur as soon as I can get my headphones, get them hooked up. At any time of my stream today, I may be chugging water. I have been really thirsty, and so I'm going to get some now, actually. Ooh, but today's drawing is going to be a Stegosaurus. And I'm going to do, I've got several reference images. I've got some that I took of an animatronic Stegosaurus at the zoo when I went the last time. And I'm going to sort of go between all the references that I can find. I know sort of the pose I want and all of that, but I had originally announced I was probably going to do something for Halloween or a dragon, and I really want to think out this idea of the dragon and maybe do a little study of it first before I start on that. But I am going to be working on tone tan paper, the same that Rexy is on. Man, I'm trying to find something. There it is. Okay. I was trying to find another pencil in my blender. All right. I'm going to move this out of the way. I'm a little confused by something today as well. It says that I have 4 followers, but if I go to my followers, I have more. And I'm not sure why. When somebody followed me yesterday, it dropped. And I am really not sure why it done that. But if you still go to where it says something about my followers, it's got 6 or something like that. But anyway, I'll get started here in just a second. At any time also in this stream, I may have to cut the air conditioner on. It's been getting really hot, and then with the air on, it gets really cold. So it's probably going to be going on and off. So I apologize about that right now. And there was one other thing I wanted to say before I got started. I don't remember what it was, though. Oh well. Let me pull up some tunes and then I'll get started. I am going to be using Derwent sketching pencils, the gray ones. These are the non-water soluble ones. I have the blue ones as well that are water soluble. Not as well, but they are water soluble where these are not. And I used these for the picture of Rexy that I just had, and this white charcoal pencil, which is by Generals. So that's probably the two main pencils I'll be using. I was asked to list what I'm probably going to be using before I start. So besides that, I have just various erasers. Let me move that out of the way. Various erasers and an eraser shield and a blending stump in my glass scene. All right. Also, it is 8:45, and if this lasts longer than like 11 to 11:30, then I will have to go and continue this on a second stream, and I have plans that I can't miss. I would have started this stream earlier, but there was something lurking outside my house this morning before it got light. I don't know if it was an animal or if it was a homeless person under a big furry blanket or what it was. But I walked out while it was still dark, to throw away some recycling before the recycling man got here. And in the driveway across from my house, there is just two empty lots, and there was this thing there, laying there, and there's a stump there, and it looked like this thing was curled up around the stump almost, and you could see it's like this fur blowing in the wind. I almost think it was a bear, actually, and when I saw it, I had just dumped that stuff in there, and it made some noise, and I was like, oh no. And so I jump up, and I'm like, okay. And I slowly get back in the house. Thankfully, it's gone now. But I would have started earlier, but I was keeping an eye out to make sure that it wasn't a bear and trying to like break in the house or anything. Or somebody trying to break in the house. I mean, you never know what a bear is going to do. So, and I have dogs, and I wanted to make sure that they were safe. So that is why I didn't start at 6 o'clock. But anyway, let's get started. So today is going to be a Stegosaurus day. Let me set up my sound, and then I will get started. There we go. Let me make sure I'm on mute here. If my phone over here rings, I'll have to pause, though. So let's get started. Again, listening to Breaking Benjamin. I think there's a trend here. I listen to them constantly all the time. If I had to, I would put myself. I don't know if I'll name this one Stego or Sarah. I think in The Land Before Time it was named Sarah, so let me zoom in right quick to if the lighting messes up, please let me know. I have the sun coming in the window here, so it might get a little bright. So please let me know if that happens. I am going to start this, though, with shapes like I normally do. I want to have about here. Now, all of my references are profiles, and I'm not going to do a profile. I'm actually going to use my imagination and do my own pose. So this might get a little wonky looking. looks like it's going to come up like this a little bit. Hello, I am streaming. If I can type. Okay. I think I might be able to zoom in one more. Alright. Let's see here. Once that light warms up, if it gets a little too bright, then please let me know. I have to have some sort of extra light. And if I do this one, it's going to put a shadow on where I'm actually drawing. All right, let's see it. Well, that gives me a little bit better look, I guess. Okay. So this head looks like it's going to come up here. I don't believe they have any ears. If they do, they're back here. This thing almost looks like a crocodile head. So this is what I think it might look like. Wow, that's bright. I gotta turn that one off. It's about to blind me. Even though I had it diffused, it was too bright. I think I'm just going to draw a back line for this. They have a shorter neck. It actually sort of dips. So I want to do this a little different, I think. I want it to... I guess I'm going to have to foreshorten it. I think that this could use a slight beak. I might not want to put that in like that yet, though. Not too heavy. I just want to sketch it out really lightly. I think this should be about here. And I think that this might actually look better if it has a little part that comes up like this and then back up to the skull on the side. And I think I'll just start with that over part of the eye instead. And I'll go back and do the other parts of it. Get out of here. Alright. Now, it starts its back about here, and this part, it's weird shaped. It sort of goes swooping up and then rounds out. And then on the bottom here, it sort of has a weird shape to it. It's almost like three lumps. It's like a chest. And then it's got a this big old back that starts coming back down when it gets closer to the tail. And then we're going to bring that tail around. Well, we're going to do it a little bit different. Oops. Okay, so the tail is about the same length as the body. I really want the tail to be front and center. So I want to foreshorten this somehow as well. I think I'm going to go back and redo this to where the body is bigger. I've noticed something weird. If it was to stand up, it would look like that duck bill. The body shape would almost. I think this actually needs to come on up and be taller. Maybe even taller right here. No, I'm gonna have to bring that back down so I can fit the spikes in. I think I'm gonna go somewhere in between those two to make it work. Hello, how are you doing today? I am drawing a Stegosaurus to go with my Tyrannosaurus. Trying to look at a reference image. I have several images and I found some animatronics of them at the zoo one time when I went, so I took some pictures of them, and I'm sort of trying to go off of those, but all of my pictures are from the wrong angles, so I'm doing most of this from imagination. Just trying to lay him out right now. I was thinking about doing a dragon, and I really want to test out the pose I have in my mind for it before I start it, so. Think that their legs are actually pretty tall, looks like. Looks like they just have three toes, or three toenails, I should say. So how are you doing today? Right. I think I've about got him laid out. Thank you.
Okay.
I think that one should come more towards me instead. No, I think these might actually come on back up a little bit like this. So I'm going to drop that one there instead, and that'll give me room for the other one, I think. trying to envision these wrapping around. Having a hard time with the placement of this one. Oops. That light is way too bright. I can't even see it. I'm going to have to do this one again, I guess. I don't want to do this. I'm going to have to cut both of these on, though, I think. I swear it sounds like something scratching behind me. Tipper, there you go, buddy. Ooh. Trying to get the setup where you can see it better with that new light. Okay. I'll go back and do the details on these a little bit later. I mainly want to get down some of the get the outlines and stuff in, then I'll start with the shading and the details and stuff. I'm getting there with the layout, at least. This one's gonna have to start the curl. This pencil, with this eraser, I can erase anything with it. I love it. That might not be the best idea to do it that way either. That's curling it a little too much too soon. No, I think if I can get it to go, so that one's straight, that one is curled, so this one actually needs to be about right. I can't seem to wrap my head around how I want to do this particular one. How it would look right. It needs to be in between straight up and curling. still think it's a little bit too far down, but I think it's that's about the best it's going to be because it's curling around. Okay. One more to do, and it shouldn't be too hard. Okay, I think I like that. All right. Let's put some detail into it now. I hope I can do this in the next hour and 10 minutes. I am not exactly sure when I'm going to have to go today. Oh, come on. Don't. Okay. Let's see here then. Oops. All right. Okay. What? I can't seem to sharpen this one to a point. My sharpener's just not big enough or something. What I'm doing is I'm going down the whole body and I'm going to put in the shading and then the shading and the highlighting, and then I'll come back and I'll go over that with the details and the, like the wrinkle lines and stuff like that. So I sort of like to go from the head then back to the tail. Okay, I'm going to do something really quick. All right. Let me know if this is too loud, if I need to lower it or what. Thank you. I'm going to do this to where it looks like cross-hatching to start with, but then I'll go back in and actually smooth it out quite a bit. I know I want this to be shaded in, so I'll come back over it afterwards and put in the detail on that as well. Probably going to be about the darkest section right here, actually. Thank you. Did I show you the Tyrannosaurus of it? Or the Tyrannosaurus I done like this? I think I did. I'm not sure. This one is a mix of several poses from Jurassic Park, actually. I really like Stegosauruses as well, so I wanted to do something with one of them. I'm going to fill in the bottom of the paper with something else as well. I'm not sure what yet, though. Is the music too loud with the stream, or is it about the same as the voiceover? Thank you. Thank you. I have a video on YouTube of it, but I didn't do it live. I done it last week on Monday or Tuesday, I believe. It is actually part of an art challenge that I am running myself, so... I write a lot of Halloween sound and music. Doesn't quite sound so Halloween-y if it has the guitars in it, but when I do the piano or the string versions of them, they always sound really, really Halloween-y. that ain't even gonna work either. That pencil is so big. Of that thing had gotten kind of, it was like it was flopping around everywhere, so. Yes, soft is the word I was looking for. I don't think I'll be back on tomorrow. I don't know about Friday, I doubt it. So it might be next week before I get to get back on, but I have, this will be 3 videos that I have to edit, and I have some other things I have to do off camera, so I don't know exactly what I'll do the next time I do stream, but like I said yesterday, I make art bookmarks, and I might do some of those, because I have to make 19 of them. Really love this tone tan paper. Gibbon, I have no idea what you said. You can get this at any craft or art store, really. It's just general white charcoal. You can buy them at, I think you might be able to buy them at some Walmarts even. You go to Michael's, Hobby Lobby, AC Moore, though, they sell these. It's just white charcoal, though. You have those where you're at. I also have a white Prismacolor that I use with my markers, and this is more of a waxy thing, where it's just charcoal. They look almost alike, but they're a little bit different, and I have used this as well with my marker stuff, and it actually makes it more translucent, like a clear coat on a car or something, than the Prismacolor does. Thanks for joining, by the way. Have to figure out what song I'm playing. Okay, I didn't recognize it because it's one of my more recently recorded ones. I think I wrote this one about 10, 12 years ago, something like that, about 10 years ago, and I adapted it to piano about a week ago, actually, I think. good thing about blending stumps is once you get them to where they're good and saturated with your graphite or your charcoal, you don't even have to put down any more. You can make a smaller gradient with them. It makes a much better shadow. I think that that's about it for the initial shading on that part. I'll have to come back in and redefine it and do more up top. And I was saying I might not finish this today. If I don't finish this on this stream here, I will come back and finish this tonight or tomorrow sometime. I have to go do something probably in 30 minutes to an hour, and after I get back I'll be able to finish the stream up. When I upload it to my YouTube, it will be on as one piece instead of two. Hopefully, anyway. Alrighty. Whew, I needed to get away from doing the pencil work for a minute. I'm going to mute my microphone for a minute and cut this air on so it'll cool off a little bit. But if for some reason I start talking and there's no sound, let me know. Thank you. My pencil squeaked. Oh, that's one thing. It's like nails on a chalkboard to hear something squeak. Wow. That just shot my nerves right there. I fixed my pencil sharpener. There was actually a piece of lead stuck in it.
Thank you.
He's actually going to have like a sort of a speckled pattern to his back that's a little bit different. I'm going to smooth this out and then go back in and do it that way, I think. I think I'm going to go on and lay down all of the white first, though. It finally cooled off in here. Alright, I think that I am about done with the white. Thank you. I'm going to give him a sort of a striped pattern, and then I'm going to go back in and sort of weave through it, I think, and it should, hopefully it'll do the pattern that I really want. So I went back and erased that other. I didn't like the way it was going down. Might have made them a little bit too far apart, but I'm gonna go back in and sort of fix that up in just a second. X-ing it now to cross it, make a slightly different pattern, and I'll go back in with the eraser and pull out what I don't want of it. Good thing about drawing dinosaurs or dragons or mythical creatures is that nobody can ever tell you, hey, that's not how it looked, because who the hell knows? Alright, let's see about pulling out some stuff. I'm going to go back in with this, the HB, and lightly go over this part. Very lightly. I want a lot of that paper's tone to be there. That's way too big. I'm going to have to go back down with that. I have another eraser I'm going to try out. I don't know. This might work. It might not work. It's a Faber-Castell Perfection Eraser. I do need to go back in with the 2B and some other places and add a little bit more of this. I've never had this thing work very successfully. See if that does the trick. Alright, that's not doing it, so what I'm going to do is go on and blend this all together, and that should give it a little bit of a different look, and I can come back in with the needed eraser then and take out what I want out. Still have a little bit of that pattern there, so that's what I'm going for. Might get a little tedious. I had to cut my air back on, but now what I'm going to do is go back through with my HB again and try to darken up some of these other areas. Since there's already tone down there, I don't really want to blend it out anymore, though. And with the HB, I can sort of get darker than the blended area, and then I can go back with the 2B and get even darker. So might look like chicken scratch on it or something, but it's texturing it. It's like very light wrinkles. I wish that my camera could actually pick up all of the fine details on it. You really can't see half of what I'm putting down on it. Sorry about that. I'm probably going to have to go in about 10 minutes, 10 to 15 minutes, and then I'll be back to finish the rest of it. I don't have that much more left, but I'll be back to finish the rest of it sometime in the next few hours after that. Probably, I might be back by 12:30. It's 11:30 now, so I might be back in an hour or an hour and a half or something like that. I'm going to go on and stop the music there as well. I've got a lot of detail into this thing already, but it is going to take a lot more for me to be happy with it. I love it, but I mean, I'm just not exactly happy with all of the details yet. I have no idea if they had any sort of things in between their spines or their spikes or whatever you want to call them. I guess they're little fins or whatever. But I am adding an exterior ridge. It's like I said, though, if you are drawing something that, you're drawing something that nobody knows what it looked like exactly, then you can make it look like whatever you want to. Yes, I've seen Jurassic World. It comes out on home video, DVD, Blu-ray on October 20th, and I cannot wait. By the way, while I'm thinking about it, happy birthday to Jessica if she ever watches this. I was planning to go to the zoo today, but I didn't get to. It would have. Let's see. It would have been, I think it would have been 3 or 5 years since I had been to the zoo. But, oh well. Maybe I'll get to go this weekend or sometime soon anyway. I love the zoo. If there was a real Jurassic World or a Jurassic Park, I would love to go. No, I've never drawn a raptor. I actually really dislike the raptors. They are my least favorite dinosaur because of how they are always the main bad guys in the Jurassic Park movies. Besides number 3 in Jurassic World. But, I love the Spinosaurus. But I felt that they really gave the raptors way too much screen time as the main villain in those movies, and I just don't like them for that reason. I might draw a Spinosaurus, though. I really love the Spinosaurus. I don't know about Indominus Rex. I might draw him or her. I don't know yet. I can put a raptor on my list, though. I keep hearing weird noises. I don't know what it is. Ah. Okay. My desk is hitting something over here when I lean on it. Unfortunately, when I come back, I know I'm going to have the air the whole time. It has gotten pretty hot up here. Name off any dinosaurs you might want to see me draw, and I'll try to find some sort of reference of them and draw them, though. I love dinosaurs. It's one of my favorite things, so I'd be happy to try to draw them. Well, I would say a portrait, trying to draw a portrait because I'm really bad at them. And the bad thing is I have 3 portraits as commissions that I have to do, and I am desperately trying to practice on them in my spare time to get better at doing portraits, but I cannot get drawing from a picture. If the person is in front of me, I can draw them. But if I draw it from a picture, for some reason, I cannot get their face right. Even with a tool that helps you measure and put it down a proportional divider. All right. I am going to have to cut this air back on, unfortunately. Ooh, it's done got hot in here. My mom actually is trying to get me to draw two of her dogs that have long hair. And I haven't drawn them for her. I've drawn her five of her other dogs that she's had over the years. And she is throwing a fit because I've not drawn those two for her. And it's because they have the long hair. And I don't know, long hair intimidates me when I'm drawing. I've just never figured out how to do it. I actually think one of the most difficult things I've ever drawn in all is actually a comic book. Simply because there's so much of it to do, and it's not, I don't try to make everything perfect in my comic books that I draw like most people do, or my comics strips that I do. But I try to do a comedy thing with the one that I do right now, if I ever get a chance to work on it. But that is probably the hardest thing, because you're trying to draw the same things over and over and have a consistency with them. My comic, it's only got one release right now, and that was back in February of this year, and it's on my DeviantArt. It's called Gus. It's a crazy cowboy, but there's also a place called Tapastic, I believe, TAPASTIC.com, and I have it on there, and when I get to do more of them, I'll be posting them actually on there. So, This has me interested in trying to draw my own version of Godzilla, though. I love Godzilla, so I might decide to actually do that. Are you talking about like proportions to each, like the proportions of the eye to the nose or something like that, like proportions to each other when you talk about dimensions? Yeah, just draw all the time. And don't worry what it looks like to start with, just keep on drawing. Draw the same thing over and over if you have to, and you'll eventually get it down. If you want to draw something like a person or something, draw one feature of them until you've got it down, like the ear from several different perspectives or different angles. Maybe the eye or the mouth or something like that. I'm really bad at mouths as well, so that's something I need to sit down and do. But I done that with ears because I could not draw ears at all. And I finally sat down and done a study of them. So just practice. And my biggest tip that I can give you is everything has a shape and is built out of other shapes. So like the dinosaur is, his snout is a circle, and then you shape it into what you want it into. And then it's like a triangular cone going up his head. Just a cylinder for his neck. Almost a bean shape for his body. More cylinders for his legs and his tail. The best thing I can say about the proportions to each other, the dimensions of them and all, is if you can't get them right, try to find a thing online. It's called a proportional divider. They look like this. And I can measure, say I have a photo that's really large. I can measure, say this is the eye. And then I can come down to my drawing and put this on there and just sort of mark out where I need to go with my stuff, and then I can go through and actually draw it. Another thing you can do is take a pencil, and if you hold it out, you hold your arm out straight, and then eyeball it, and you put your thumb at the bottom and the tip at the top, and you just go through and you sort of take your hand and you'll go down and you'll mark it, but you have to stay in the same place to do that. I call that thumbing. So it's not a bad method. It's really easy to do if once you get the hang of it. As soon as I get this blended here, I have to go for a few minutes though, and I'll probably be back within an hour after I go. I'm not sure. Another good thing, which I never do, really, and I wish I did, I'll do it with this piece because I'm stepping away, but when you're drawing something, look at whatever you're doing, and then you sort of step away from it for a little while and come back with fresh eyes, and then you can look at it and say, hey, you know what, that needs this done, that needs that done. That's why I like to skip around where I'm at in the art. So if I'm working on something else, like right then, I just realized I hadn't shaded around this part of it, which I needed to do. I have no idea. I really never know what I'm going to draw next. I didn't know what I was going to draw until I actually started my stream today. I was actually planning to draw a dragon, but I decided to draw this instead because it just popped in my head. And I said, hey, my T-Rex would like a partner or something, so I wanted to do this, but I am going to put something down here on the bottom of my paper on this, so I've still got a ways to go. Stepping out for a minute is going to give me a chance to actually think about what I want to do. So I'm going to try to zoom in, see if you can see that. Some of the textures I put in there. You can see them a little better if I mess with the contrast. Get this back where I need it. Alright. I will be back probably in about an hour. Maybe hour and a half to 2 hours. I'm not really sure, but I will be back today to finish this. So I will see you later. Alright, I am back. This is the second part of my Stegosaurus stream. I'm going to wait a minute before I get started and see if my people come back in. But I wanted to say this should be joined up to the first part if it's on YouTube. And I will be trying to get those put together, hopefully. Let's see here. I found a pencil sharpener that actually works enough to let me sharpen up my stuff, so I'm very happy about that. I had to use one of these double pencil sharpeners. It's got this big old thing in it, and it's got something stuck in it now. There we go. Alright. Let's get started back on this. I don't like the way this looks after all, but I can't really do much about this now. I could add a little bit more to it right here, but I think it would make it look all wonky. Like, this is supposed to be turning, so I like that it does look like it's turning, but that's the only thing that bothers me. I wish I had have done it to where it was up here instead. I don't think I can actually get this to erase. Yeah, I can. Let's go back and see if we can erase it out a little bit then. Alright. There we go. I think I'll like that better. Let me grab that white. The wonders of an electric eraser. Now, since I sharpened this, it's not as nearly as blunt as it was. I'm going to have to be careful with it. But, I'm pretty happy with that now. Let's see if I can erase right around the edge of it. By the way, whether you're on YouTube or you're watching on here or whatever, let me know if you liked that music part that I've done earlier. That's music that I wrote and have recorded from my writing program. It's the piano versions of some of the songs that I have written over the years, and I enjoy it myself. That's why I write it like that. I just enjoy that. But it does sound really Halloween-y for some reason. Alright, let's go back in with a darker pencil and actually draw in these little veins that there are on here. And by the way, I'm sorry about the air conditioner being on. There's nothing I can really do about it now. It is really hot in here. It's about 70 outside, which means up here it's about 100 if I cut the air off. So, almost leaf-like, and they're fractured as they go down or something. It's really weird looking. I want to try to blacken the outline around the fins, or whatever they are. I don't know what they are. Back spikes or something. Plates, maybe. Actually, actually, you know what? I can do that easier if I use a 4B. Once I get these outlined, I'll go back and finish up the detailing of this. And I think that everything down here is about done. I do see I need to shade this back in. I like these pencils because they don't seem to come off on your hand if you do get your hand on top of them. I am going to mute my microphone so that you don't hear me singing. So if you see me singing and you don't hear anything, that's what's going on. Or I'm just singing under my breath. Looks like I sort of moved that one out a little bit further than it was supposed to be, so I'm going to go on back in there and try to fix it a little bit. So all of them seem like they have a center part, and what I'm going to do is start splitting them off like, and then do something like that. You know, just randomly do this mainly. It's like these are huge bones, and they have all these little fractures in them and stuff, so. My original plan was to do them like this, to where they all originated from the bottom, but I think it looks much better with fracturing off to the sides and stuff. Oh, this is going to be hard for me to finish this. Oh, my hand is hurting already. I actually like the way that done, so I am going to do that same thing with all of them. I'm going to start with the middle one, and then have two on either side, and then I'll come back and actually fix these. And if I go over where there was old marks, it's fine, because I can come back and do those with the lighter pencil again anyway. Hey there, and welcome to the stream. I hate that I had to leave earlier. I had plans that I had to take care of, so I would have been done with this a lot sooner if whatever that was hadn't have been out there this morning. I'm a pretty brave guy. I've actually had somebody pull a gun on me before. Don't really tell many people that, but I stood right there and I faced them down. But whatever that was, that scared the hell out of me. I don't know if it was a bear or what it was. Alright, I think that I should be able to do the rest of this without messing with that thing too much. It looks like the Derwent pencil sharpener would sharpen these to a darn point. I can't even get it in that side. That makes me mad. That's a little bit better. If you really want to see all of the detail that I'm putting into it, you'll have to check it out on my DeviantArt once I get it up there. I will go on and put it up after I get done with this stream. I'll take a photo of it and put it up there. But I think that the details really set it off, but the camera, I don't think it really lets you see much of it. This song I call Thumpity Thump Thump. It's Water by Breaking Benjamin. I love the rhythm to it, the groove. Alright, I think I have got them pretty well spined up and fractured up. Okay. I didn't fracture these up, so I gotta do that right quick. Alright. I want a texture to these. So I'm going to do lines. Where they meet the back, I really want them to have a darker look to them too. Hello there, welcome to the stream. Might go back and smooth that part of it out a little bit. These I don't think are going to matter too much if I put much in there. Hello, thanks for joining. I need to put something on the bottom of it, but I don't know what I want to put down there. I was thinking about another small one, but I really don't feel like drawing something like that right now. I think I'll do maybe some grassy look or something. Alright, I think that I am about done with it. Let's put a name on it. I think we should call this one Stego. I might go back in and put a little bit more shading into it. If anybody has a request for another dinosaur besides the T-Rex or the Stegosaurus now, let me know. I have a raptor already on the list to do. I thought that I outlined the one on the Tyrannosaurus. Thought I outlined its name in black, but I didn't. Oh well. Let me go back and make sure I've got everything the way I want it to be. I think I'm going to go back with the 2B. Start adding in a little bit more of the details in different places. I kind of like the way it looks. He's sort of elephant skinned. Okay, there we go with Stego. That's a good name as any, I guess. So that's Stego, and my first one was Rexy. I want to look at them and make sure I've got everything the way I want them. So I actually see something I want to do now. I need my 4B. Not everything needs an outline around it, but I think with this, it really looks better with that outline on it. Alright. I believe I'm done with it. Let me do something right quick. One more thing I have to do. Let's see, what is today's date? Alrighty. Thank you everybody who has dropped in on my stream today. Thank you for, if you're watching this on YouTube later. I really enjoyed this a lot. I'll probably be back to cartooning next week, but I don't think I will be doing another stream this week. I'm not sure. I do know that I have quite a bit that I need to do. So if I get done with everything else, then I'll go on and do another stream probably. But until then, I probably won't. Let's see here. As always, if you have a request or you want to add something to my list, I have Facebook. You can go to fb.me/solomichaelk. You can go to Twitter. I am st017 on Twitter. And just leave me something there. I also have a DeviantArt, which is solo013. And you can check me out there and see the final versions of these if you want to. I'm going to get this photographed and put up on my DeviantArt. So I will see you later.